on the outside of it. So from there, I want to change. So in effect, I've got behind it without moving. I am now in the advantageous position. Number two. Straight block. If the energy still continues this way, cross block. And then I come in with my follow-up technique from here. Three. This was a straight punch, remember. It ties the racket out to the side. Now, every foot movement by itself should be able to be defended. The blocks are one for extra security and two to lead you into follow-up technique. So number three, straight block, reach out. Cross block is obviously then with the other hand. One point about changing from straight to cross is that each time we change, we take out the elbow. So here, gentle hook over. So the block has the effect of a strike to break the elbow. Four. Straight. Hook over. We don't go bang and then come back and start again. Any damage that's done is done on the way through the technique. Cross. Five. Parry, pivot on with your foot, hips out of the way, down, straight. I'll show cross on the other side so you can see better. Straight block is always staying behind your foot, pivot. Not stepping forward because it's coming from close in. There's no time to step forward or there's not the distance. Cross block is the other hand which allows me to use this for striking, etc. Or as I come around, taking down. We'll be going over these all in the course of the day, but the reason I'm showing you now is so you've got an overview before we start what we're doing. Seven and eight. So seven, low punch, back at 45 degrees. His momentum is coming forward, so I don't want to stand in his way here if I can help it. Off at an angle, straight block. Cross block is then with the other hand. Now, because the energy from this parry is taking his arm forward, this is coming back. You've got the effect again of breaking the elbow. There. And then again. Eight. Straight. Cross. Not let go here because you can pull that hand back and hit me with it again before I'm coming with a cross block. Slice underneath parry if you want to take, if you want to keep it into a lock. So basically straight, cross. Nine and ten. In a situation where you have a chance to get out of the way, going back in a straight line. Nine, first punch. Nine, back. Cat stance, make a washy dash. Parry. When the reverse punch comes through, where it comes forward. And the break here on the elbow ends up when you turn around this way. Now, all these are done against two people later on. Because I can do this, it comes from a battlefield arm. You never stand still. So at a higher level, we do everything against attacks from both sides. Which we'll move on, we'll get on to during the course. Ten, the other side, one, and obviously I'm coming forward here and I've opened up in the centre for whatever I want my next technique to be. Turn from the mat down, please. That series of movements, the angles of the attack and the movements for the defence are what we're going to use for all the techniques we do today. I'll explain later on. Once we've been through the Taisabaki for a certain technique, we practice that technique. Let's say Shiinagi, because some of you are familiar with. Once we've done Shiinagi against all these angles of attack, remember, not against all these punches, but against all these angles of attack, we then start using it against any conceivable body part. So the principle of Shiinagi is learned, and then you apply it however it needs to be applied in the situation. And different people will apply it in different ways. That doesn't matter. What is important is that you employ the principle and it works for you. So we'll start with any questions, by the way, before we move on. Now from here, the actual technique, I'm going to step up, my back foot to the front foot, and I'm going to go across him at an angle. Actually, you lot down there won't be able to see. Can you come down here, please? This way. Turning your arms in, enveloping him. So, straight block, Uddiyucci, strike. Turn before I'm going to do something. Left foot up to right, and then himself is irrelevant. What's relevant in Kazunashiru is the way he goes down. That's what determines the throw. Not what I do, but what happens to him. Number two again. We'll stick to Kobayashi for now. One. Strike. Now as you strike, you see, this hip comes through. So it's on its way around. Anyway, it's coming this way. And this is Kokunage 1 and 2. We go through Kokunage against all the strikes, so we get to that number 9 and 10. And that is called the Taisabaki for Kokunage. And then we'll do it against all kind of bodyguards, etc. Right, let's have a bash. We'll do the footwork together first. Okay, up you get it. Strike. Now, sneak back, in and then out. Left foot to right, and forward. Good. Back. Number two, exactly the same thing, opposite direction. So straight block, long. Strike. Right foot to left, and then out again. Towards the corner. Point down, sink your energy low. Back push forward. Number two, straight block. Strike, make sure your hips are already starting to come up. In, out. Oh, so what is number two? You're not trying to do this. Not in here, in this. You're not trying to push. What is off at that front foot? So when you come in behind it, point your fingers towards each other so that that's very forward, because you might want to follow up. Okay? So the idea is not to throw in as far as possible. Not just projecting out, but crushing. Not just physically, but psychologically as well. Making clear that the shifters are coming in all the time. Off you go, with your partner, please. One side, Kokunage 1 and 2 now against the straight one. Let's just see. One, round, and through. If, as I said before, when if you're not pushing up with your straight block, well, if he comes in with a really strong punch, he gets there before I move, and all I can do is put my hand up here. I'm not going to start going like this then. Okay? So that's when we've got to use cross block. hit with any strike, my first reaction is the defensive triangle. And from there, that's when I start my block or parry. I can decide to go straight block, cross block, move out straight block number three, straight block number seven, whatever. So it's not a case of this arm goes there. What you must do is protect your centre so the defensive triangle comes up. So, number three, it's like a knife hand block as you step out to the side. But the difference between this and a karate block, say, is number four. If I strike, as soon as I make hard contact here, the nerve impulse is going to go to the brain and tell me to be blocked. So, the way we do it in Kajurashi Ryu is to stop that. Well, as soon as I make contact, I want my arm to have a ball bearing type effect on his arm. And I want to let him take it. Moving his arm past me without him realising it's gone past until the very last moment, at which time it'll be too late to do anything. So it's always this soft time. Remember that numbers 1 and 2? Number 2, we start at palm in and roll out forward. Same with all the pipes. So number 4, step out to the side, roll it. So we've got this action. Koki Nagi, number 3. Show you first, then I swear. Number three, what we're going to do here, this bottom hand is going to go in his